just takes you back to that summer, doesn't it, Alfie? Tell us what, you know, amazing place to sing.
Oh, absolutely.
It?
Incredible place, an incredible honour to be invited onto a royal balcony.
I want to know what you saw on the way to the balcony. You know, what's...
We were blindfolded, and no, we weren't.
we can't tell me. No,
it was wonderful. It was beautiful. You know, regular, nice decorations. The room that was behind the balcony was an Oriental room, and it was brought up from Queen Victoria's Palace in Brighton, actually. So it's transferred from there. And it's gorgeous. Murals on the ceiling and art and everything. It was wonderful.
Was that the first time you'd performed that since you were cast as Tony in a production in Preston?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah, exactly. I've not sung that for many years. So it was really bizarre. Next time I'm going
to
sing it. It's
slightly different from Preston to...
A little bit.
Nothing wrong with Preston.
No, but quite different. I mean, for the second time I sing it, to be on the Royal Balcony, it was incredible. Really cool.
Were you nervous?
I was, yeah. But then being on the balcony, looking over the whole event, there was an element of separation because the distance from the audience and the distance from the orchestra as well. So we had monitors on the floor. We had a screen with the conductor on it so we could see when to come in and things. So occasionally you can see me looking down, panicking, like, where am I?
I'm so glad you've explained that to me. I was wondering why you were looking down.
You've written... your autobiography is out. Now,
yes.
At the beginning, it's really extraordinary chapter, which I had no idea about. Was it when you were preparing... appear in the Pearl Fishers.
Yeah.
Was it a Cotton Bowl?
It was the English National Opera, the Colosseum.
Okay, the Colosseum.
Yeah, yeah.
You got really, really ill.
And
got so demoralised by that you considered actually packing it all in.
Yeah, it was a difficult time that, you know, I think my health had suffered quite badly. You know, I'd got an element of chlorine poisoning, which was really, really bad.
Which is an unusual thing to get as an opera singer.
It is, yeah.
Where did you get that from?
Well, I was filming in a... film tank. We were doing Pearl Fishers, so they wanted to shoot an image of me in the background swimming. So we'd done this full day of swimming in a tank, and it was a crazy day, but you know, effective. The actual result looked great, but I suffered for it a little bit. You know, I was being sick, and it was awful. I won't go into details, but it was terrible.
So how close did you come though then to become also a fitness instructor?
Well, that was before that. I was spending quite a lot of time away from family and travelling a lot with the job and spending a lot of time on the road. I was really missing my kids and missing my wife, and I wanted to, you know, and think the record industry for me at that time had slumped a little bit and things weren't taking off as much as I would have liked. And I was just getting a bit down about it all and Then that incident happened, and it was just one thing after another. But, you know, I knew I wouldn't be happy. There was something inside of me still telling me that just carry on, just keep going. You won't be happy if you don't do this. So,
and I know that you've written a book, and one of the reasons you said the book is that so you don't have to answer this question.
Yeah.
The question is, how did you get from being a car mechanic to an opera singer? So let's just do it one more time.
Oh, my goodness.
You must have it down.
I was singing in a car factory, polishing a car, and a customer overheard me singing and said, "You've got a really good talent. Go away to London and sing for the national Doyle Car Opera Company and see if they'll take you on."
And they did.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, remarkable fairy tale career story told in 8 seconds.
There you go.
And now you're singing your favourite songs on an album, including
Bridge Over Troubled Water.
Here we go. Let's have a look.
You've done lots of cover versions, haven't you?
Yeah.
I mean, Elvis.
Yeah, there's two Elvis.
Brilliant.
Two Elvis. Three Elvis tracks on the album. There's two Rolling Stones tracks. There's a Walker Brothers track, The Sun Ain't Gonna Shine. Harry Nilsson's Everybody's Talking.
All favourites of yours.
All favourites of mine. There's some American blues songs at the end of the album as well, towards the end. So it's quite a mixture of things. But songs I just love to sing and that suit my voice, you know.
You've rocked the opera boat in the past with the comments. thought about opera. And also, but when you were training,
I love the way you bring this up, Billy.
Well, no, I'm trying to glide over it.
I
was going to add to the pour more fuel on the fire. Because it, also, when you were training, you just didn't like it, did you? I mean, you just didn't like the way that they were bringing you along.
No, it was a difficult time as well. That, but you know, people say, would I go back and would I change anything? And I always say no, because that's what makes you the artist that you are, and who you are, and how you've developed in the business. But no, when I was working at the Opera House, I didn't like the way that they were saying the way you had to be an opera singer, the way that they were describing a stereotypical opera singer. They wanted to sort of break you down and rebuild you after 2 years. And
you think part of it is also that you are rebellious in nature?
I think it was all my fault. It was all down to me. There you go.
What would you say to people who are car mechanics or whoever they are, singing, enjoying the singing, that this is possible to go on and do it as a career? Or is this, lucky one?
No, I think everybody's got an opportunity. I think everybody's got the chance. It's just recognising those chances and going for them with your gut instinct, you know.
Alfie, lovely to see you. Thank you.
Great to hear the old stories.
Oh, bless you. I know. I'll see you next time.
In 8 seconds. Brilliant.
Cheers, Alfie. Alfie's new album, Storyteller, is out now.
Thank you. We will be speaking more to